The transformation of Shasta Lake has left Californians in awe, from a drastic drought to a nearly overflowing lake as the water levels rise. However, experts are afraid that the water sustainability of this lake is still uncertain. So how exactly did Shasta Lake experience such a dramatic turnaround of overflowing resources? What lies in the future of this lake? Will it flourish or dry up, similar to the Trinity Lake nearby? What has scared the scientists so much? Today, we'll delve into the astonishing journey of Shasta Lake's resurrection. Shasta Lake, the Central Valley Project's cornerstone, is a reservoir that can be found in Shasta County, California. The lake is the biggest artificial lake in the entire state and is located directly on the upper Sacramento River. 10 miles north of Redding is where you'll find Shasta Lake if you look it up on the map. Shasta Lake's history dates back to the early 1900s, when construction on the enormous Shasta Dam began. Standing tall at an astounding 602 feet, this dam was a considerable feat of engineering. Shasta's dam's construction dammed up three significant rivers in the north state. MacLeod and Sacramento referred to the pit as having arms. Each still has its personality, setting, background, and recreational opportunities. The second tallest concrete dam in the entire county is the Shasta Dam. It took some time, but the dam was finished by 1945, and Lake Shasta was filled by 1948. Shasta Lake was created in this manner. Shasta Lake has a massive area of 30,000 acres, and the lake can hold about 4,552,000 acre-feet of water, and rises 1,067 feet above sea level at a complete pool. That places it right behind Lake Tahoe and California's top three most significant bodies of water, the Salton Sea. If you dive deep enough, Shasta Lake's deepest point is about 517 feet below the surface. That's extremely deep. Lake Shasta has been a significant water source for hydroelectric power, agriculture, and most importantly, flood risk management. However, it's also a tranquil haven for thrill seekers. For boating, fishing, water skiing, and camping lovers, it's a dream location with more than 370 miles of breathtaking shoreline. The lake, however, has encountered its fair share of difficulties. Water levels and important reservoirs all over the state fell due to a three-year drought that was particularly severe around Lake Shasta. This raises the question of how Lake Shasta went from being in severe drought to nearly overflowing. California experienced a severe drought between 2020 and 2022, which led to dangerously low water levels, alarming the locals and nearly emptying the reservoir. The lake was only 24% full, and about 175 feet below the top of the dam in September 2021. Can you believe that Shasta Lake was last full in 2019? But it rose to a record-breaking height of 1,064.5 feet. The Golden State has been dealing with a protracted drought ever since. Recreational pursuits suffered, and it was hard on the ecosystem. The state's drought had gotten so bad by the end of last year that many organizations that depended on water from the reservoir were given very little to no allocations. The bare minimum needed for health and safety was provided to some water districts and cities in the state's northern region that supply drinking water. But when 2023 arrived, everything was different. There were several causes for the sudden rise in the water levels. The first and foremost factor was that California went through a significant change in weather patterns, with more rain than usual. Shasta Lake and other local water resources were refilled as a result. Additionally, a significant amount of water entered the reservoir after winter storms dumped more snow than usual in western Shasta County. The water levels gradually rose again due to a healthier snowpack and more rain. Since the beginning of 2023, the lake's water levels have increased by nearly 150 feet, reaching 1,063.87 feet above sea level as of May 9th, just 3.2 feet below Shasta's maximum capacity of 1,067 feet. This level, which was observed in May, is the highest level ever observed at this time since the year 2019. The 2019 high of 1,064.5 feet is higher than this record. Shasta Lake's water levels changed dramatically in just a year, as evidenced by images taken by NASA's Earth Observatory. Pictures taken between November 18, 2022 and May 29, 2023 showed the lake's recovery. By the end of May, it had gone from only 31% full to 98% complete. And that bathtub ring that used to indicate where the water once was vanished. Remember that Shasta Lake's total capacity is approximately 1,067 feet above sea level in November 2022. To put things in perspective, it had dropped to around 918 feet. However, it increased to 928 feet by January 2023. It also reached an impressive 1,063 feet as of May 29th, only 3 feet short of full pool status. As of July 9th, the water level is 1,054 feet above sea level, which is 13 feet below the complete pool, which is excellent for this time of year. Talk about a complete turnaround for a lake once suffering from drought. Lake Oroville significantly increased the volume of nearby reservoirs. By May 29th, the second largest reservoir in California was astonishingly 97% full. These reservoirs are essential for the Central Valley's irrigation system, water storage, and flood control. They also offer recreational opportunities. But while Northern California's Shasta Lake and Lake Oroville are thriving, Trinity Lake is having a different experience. Trinity Lake is significantly below its average level at only 39% capacity. The water level is 120 feet lower when measured from the top of the dam. You might wonder why Shasta Lake is thriving while Trinity Lake is struggling. The 3 years that Trinity Lake experienced the worst drought ever noted for that reservoir, the last time conditions were favorable and the water level was at its average level, was in 2019. Trinity Lake had low storage levels at the beginning of the year due to the severe drought that lasted for a long time. However, there are other differences between how these two reservoirs fill up. With a large drainage basin, Lake Shasta has the advantage of filling up more quickly all year. On the other hand, the poor Trinity Lake has a much smaller basin, so it takes longer for the snow on the mountains to melt and fill the lake. It's difficult for Trinity Lake to catch up in just one season because the drainage area above the dam is so constrained. The exciting part is now here. The Sierra Nevada mountains have an above average snowpack due to the recent wet weather in the area. Intense atmospheric river storms dumped tons of snow on the Sierra Nevadas, setting records for snowpack. When spring arrives, the temperatures rise, melting all of the snow. It trickles down to the mountains, entering the reservoirs to help restock them. The freshwater supply in California depends significantly on that snowpack. About 30% of the state's water comes from it. When it melts, streams and rivers have a significantly increased flow, which helps to fill those reservoirs in the spring and early summer. It's a natural reservoir high in the mountains and may even raise Lake Shasta's water levels. But wait a moment. Even though the rapid melt seems lovely, it raises some issues, particularly regarding flooding. This is because the soil in the western United States has become extremely dry due to the protracted mega drought we've been experiencing. If it falls slowly, the soil will only have time to absorb all that melted snow. This could worsen the effects of the drought by causing flash flooding in Central Valley Lake, Clear, and Yosemite. Furthermore, the region's need for careful water management is amplified by depleted groundwater supplies and aquifers. We must strike a delicate balance between getting enough water and preventing floods. It may appear that abundant water will end California's droughts, but things are more complicated than that. The necessary groundwater supplies cannot correctly replenish due to the dry soils and risk of flash flooding. An attorney for environmental and energy-related issues named Laura Fowler explained that increased groundwater pumping has led to further aquifer level declines, impacting stream water flow. Groundwater recharge is a lengthy process that involves several steps, years with rainfall amounts that are above average for the season. What information do experts offer about Lake Shasta's future and what that means for California? The recent water boom is extremely welcome after such a protracted drought, but that doesn't mean that all of our water problems will be fixed by magic. What the future of water will be for Lake Shasta and the rest of California is still unknown. There is some good news though. The Bureau of Reclamation's Area Manager for Northern California, Don Bayer, is upbeat about the situation. Throughout the summer, he anticipates Lake Shasta to remain at a high water level and believes that the anticipated drop in water level of 40 to 50 feet by September would be advantageous for recreational activities. Additionally, he's optimistic that the area will experience the typical winter storms, which could cause Lake Shasta to refill completely. Professor of Hydrogeology Graham Fogg wants to keep us in reality. Although the recent rain has been beneficial, he reminds us that it won't entirely undo the effects of the drought. Even when reservoirs are complete, there may only sometimes be enough water. We've seen firsthand how quickly reservoir levels can fluctuate. Well, what do you think will happen with the water levels in the future? Let us know in the comments section below. We'll see you in our next video.